Hello students, in this session we will study the module phase control rectifier and bridge inverters. All university questions we will cover in this session. First question will be that with a neat circuit diagram and waveform, explain single phase, full wave and half control rectifier circuit. So this is the question which is regarding about single phase, full wave, half control rectifier circuit with resistive load. And also with this question, one derivation will be there to derive output voltage equation. So this is the circuit diagram of single phase, full wave, half control rectifier circuit. In this circuit diagram, the two SCRs device are used and two diodes are used with resistive load. And for this circuit, single phase is used. L is the live point of single phase AC supply and N is the neutral point. Now, waveform, this is the single phase waveform. Second waveform is regarding the load voltage across the load major. And third waveform is current through the load, that is load current with respect to the time. Now, during positive half cycle of AC supply, this live point is more positive than the neutral point. Therefore, SCR1 and diode 1 is forward bias and SCR2 and diode D2 is reverse bias. Due to reverse bias, this diode D2 and SCR2 will be off and only there will be active element SCR1 and D1. So, the current path will flow from live point of single phase SCR, then load resistance, and then it will come back to the D1 and to neutral point. So, in this case, live point is more positive with respect to neutral point. Now, this during positive half cycle, the theory will be like this. Alpha is the delay angle between alpha to pi. In single phase, full wave, half control circuit, components already we discussed, that is two SCRs and two diodes and one resistive load is there. So in this duration, from 0 to pi, positive half cycle of AC supply, live point is more positive and therefore S1 and D1 are forward bias. So here angle will be 0 to pi. That is, now during time interval pi to pi plus alpha, see in this waveform, that is, see in this waveform, alpha to pi. Here, alpha to pi during this interval, that is, this when single phase crosses pi time interval, the SCR1 and D1 will be reverse bias, and from interval pi to pi plus alpha, that is during negative half cycle, the negative half cycle, the diode D1 and SCR1 is off, but SCR2 and diode D2 will be on. So this is the load voltage across load waveform. So 0 to pi SCR will be off, here pi to alpha SCR1 and D1 on. Next, when it will process pi, that time SCR1 and D1 are off during negative half cycle, this SCR2 will be on, that is forward bias, and D2 will be forward bias. So during this interval, this SCR2 and diode are forward bias. The current path will be from neutral SCR2, load resistance due to and live point. So in this the neutral point is more with respect to light form. Now during so cycle will be repeated again. Now when AC supply crosses 2π interval, that time this SCR2 and B2 will be turned off, and again SCR1 and SCR diode 1 will be on, that is forward bias. So due to resistive load, this voltage across the load and current through load will be in same phase, that is therefore the waveform will be same like load voltage and the load current. So this is the theory about the single phase full wave half control circuit. Now we will see the derivation for output voltage. Derivation is load voltage is equal to 1/π integration alpha to pi Vm sin omega t d omega t. Integration of sin omega t is minus cos omega t. Here we take Vm is the constant, we take outside. So the limits will be alpha to pi. Here we put limits cos omega t, cos pi minus cos alpha. So here minus to this bracket we multiply. So equation will be VL DC voltage is equal to Vm pi in bracket 1 plus cos of alpha. So this is the average value of load voltage or DC value. Next is the RMS value of load voltage. During RMS we will take the formula under root of square of this Vm sin square of this formula, that is Vm square sin square omega t. So sin square omega t we replace 1 minus cos of 2 omega t upon 2. So in this way we get the formula. This is the RMS value of load voltage. So for this question we also derive the output load voltage DC as well as RMS. So this is the end of this question. So question is that single phase full wave and half control rectifier circuit.
Stop share now. Record now.